today's NFL, it's no given that you have a kicker that's so accurate. I think since that Detroit game last year where Mason missed 5 kicks, he's 96 for 99. How reliable has he been? How much of a luxury has that been for you guys to have him?
Oh, he's been clutch. He's been making clutch kicks all season long. You think a couple weeks back in the Giants and bad field position or bad field conditions. So it's awesome when you have a kicker that you can count on.
Matt, does it mean anything to you to be coaching in the 200th Packers-Bears game as far as the history of this rivalry? And do you have any connection or memories at all of Packers-Bears from like growing up in Michigan or anything like that?
Not a ton. Just to be coaching in the National Football League, that is as special as it gets. And then you talk about being able to coach for the Green Bay Packers. I don't think it gets any better than that. And then a game of this magnitude, a meaningful game late in the season, that means a lot to both teams. So, yeah, it's awesome.
The Bears didn't show you David Montgomery too much in week one. They counted on him a lot. Since then, recently, how much has he progressed?
We were really impressed with him coming out of the draft. Big, he's a physical back, and from what I've seen from him, he's running that way, and he's done a lot of good things. And I think he's a versatile guy as well. So we got to have a good plan for him this Sunday.
You know, back to the Bears stuff. It is such obviously steep in tradition. Is that something that you have to go research when you come in here, just so you have the historical background to pass on to the younger players who also don't have that, or how does that work?
I don't think so. Okay. I think this is a National Football League. You got a job to do, no matter who you're playing, and I think it's more for the fans than anything else. But certainly, it's a division game, and those games are so meaningful. And you have 6 division games all season long, so. We've made a big emphasis on winning those division games, and it just so happens that just where we are in the season right now with where we sit within the division and what's at stake, it's a huge game.
How much does it change things for your defensive coaches when they run Mitch Trubisky 64 yards last week after he had, I think, 80 all year going into that? Does it find a little more that they have to prep for this week?
Yeah, I just think it goes back to what we talked about the other day, is just making sure that we're extremely disciplined in everything we do. We know that he's a threat in the run game with some of the zone read stuff, and then also being disciplined with our rush lanes, making sure that we try to keep him bottled up, so because he is an athletic guy and he can make off-schedule throws, and if it's not there downfield, he can pull it and run it.
What's happened to MVS? I realize he was hurt back in early October when he's played through it, but he just hasn't done a whole lot for you the last 6 games.
Yeah, I think the effort's there, and I just think it's been limited opportunities, and that's our responsibility to make sure that we put him in there, and if the opportunity presents itself, then he's got to take advantage of it.
Even snap count-wise, though, that's really dwindled here the last couple. I think he had, 10 on Sunday?
Yeah, I don't know what the exact number was, but I talked about it last week in terms of we moved Devontae over to the X position, so that obviously is going to limit some of those snaps as well.
Matt, in your experience when you've been a play caller and you have to deal with elements, what affects your play calling sheet, if you will, more so? Is it you've got cold temperatures or wind or precipitation? What kind of things really affect what you can do?
Yeah, I think it totally depends on, first of all, what your players can do, is specifically, more importantly, the quarterback. We're fortunate that we have a guy that's, well-versed in playing in bad conditions, and he's got the arm strength to, whether it's windy or he's got big hands, so the rain doesn't affect him too much. So that's a luxury that we have. But certainly if you don't have that, then it definitely can kind of get you out of some things and dictate what you call.
Sometimes can you have to maybe micromanage a little bit? If you have a significant wind in one direction, I've got to get these plays in before the end of the quarter. I want to run, I want to finish this drive before the end of the quarter because it's going to adversely affect us when we switch sides.
Yeah, I think you always take that into account. But like I said, I haven't had to think about it too much this season, even when it has been bad, because, like I said, Aaron's so good in those conditions.
Hey, Matt, with Adrian, what has he meant to the secondary this year? And have you kind of seen him hit his stride here this last few games with settling back into that more traditional safety role and what he's doing back there?
Yeah, I think he's been awesome in terms of just, you know, consistency. And it is nice that we've had the majority of our secondary available, really the majority of our team available most of the season. So, but just a calming veteran presence that can make plays on the football. And, you know, just a consistent guy, all whether it's practice, game, he's the same every day, and you can always count on him.
And where's Kevin King at this week after not being able to go last week?
Yeah, I think he's in a good spot right now. So we'll see how he progresses. You know, he's still got another day, and then we got 3 days till game time. So, but I like where he's at right now.
Matt, do you take it as a challenge at all, or a compliment, I guess I should say, that teams talk about stopping your run game now, it's about stopping Aaron Jones? Do you think that that's a sign of how far you've come with your run game?
I think it's a little bit of both. You know, I think there's still a lot more out there in terms of consistency in the run game. But no, we're fortunate. Not only, I know everybody talks about Aaron, but I can't emphasize enough how important Jamal is to us as well. Both those guys, they run hard. They make people miss. I feel like they're always falling forward. And I think that's absolutely critical in terms of the run game is that you are falling forward, because those are kind of like hidden yards, if you will, as opposed to if you're falling laterally, you're getting one or two extra yards every time you're going down.
How would you assess Aaron's ability, not just falling forward, but there's been times when he's had first contact 3 yards in the backfield and somehow still getting 5 yards out of it. How elite is that skill set for him? How rare is that?
Yeah, I think it is an elite skill set, and there's nothing better as a play caller when you're sitting there and you're thinking in your mind, I've got to get it ready for 2nd and 13, and it's 2nd and 5. So it keeps you on track and gives you confidence that, you know, even if it's not the perfect look or it's not blocked up perfectly, that you can get positive yards, and that helps ensure getting more runs called.
Is it a different vibe around here this week with 3 games to go? You're in first place and there's so much on the line. Is it, you notice that at all, or maybe even building to get to this?
No, I think, you know, it's just like I said, I mean, they're all these games are important, but it's the next game, and as boring as it sounds, hit the reset button every week and we're going to try to go 1-0.
Dean said he thought coaches are in a little bit better mood with everything that's at stake and how well you guys are doing. Do you agree with that? Are you in a better mood? Were you in a bad mood before?
I don't know. I mean, I guess you'd have to take a poll of the team. I don't know. I try to stay as consistent as possible.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel.